This is the second video in a three-part series which will guide you through the process of creating a new Dodeca application. In this video, we'll import Essbase connections as well as discuss the connection properties utilized within Dodeca. Again, there are six basic steps to creating a new Dodeca application. In the previous video, we covered the first four steps in the process. In this video, we'll cover the fifth step in creating a new application, importing Essbase connection information. Let's go ahead and return to our newly created finance application. The easiest way to configure Essbase connections is to use the Import Essbase Connections wizard. To use the wizard, select Admin, Quick Start Utilities, and Import Essbase Connections from the menu. This form can be used to import your Essbase connections. You can also create new connections manually through the Essbase Connections metadata editor from the admin menu. The Essbase Service URL defaults to the location where the Dodeca servlet is installed. In most cases, the Dodeca Essbase servlet is installed in the same location as the Dodeca servlet, but if this is not the case in your environment, you'll need to update the URL to reflect the correct location. If you've previously imported Essbase connections, Dodeca will remember the Essbase service URLs and make them available in the dropdown. Enter your Essbase username and password. And then click Connect. For this tutorial, we'll only be importing the sample basic connection. Select the checkbox next to sample basic and then click Import. Press OK to confirm the request and import the selected connections. Once you've imported the sample basic connection, press Close to return to the Essbase Connections metadata editor. Select sample.basic from the metadata editor to view the properties of our newly imported connection. Since this may be your first experience with metadata editors in Dodeca, let's take a couple of minutes to describe some of the important features of metadata editors in general. This is a property grid style metadata editor. For any Dodeca object, in our case an Essbase connection to the sample basic database, there will be a list of property categories displayed. In the case of an Essbase connection, the categories are clusters, Essbase, information, logging, and miscellaneous. Categories are denoted in the property grid by bolded black text with a gray background. Categories are simply a way of grouping properties together in terms of function. You'll notice that some of the property values are bolded and some are not. Bolded text indicates that the property value has been changed or otherwise does not match the default property value expected by the server. Non-bolded values, such as do Essbase performance logging equals false, match the default value for the Dodeca server and are in fact not even stored in the Dodeca database. You should also notice that for every property you select, there's a description that is displayed in the Property Description panel at the bottom of your Dodeca instance. An ellipsis at the end of a description indicates that the remarks do not fit entirely in the given space. To display the extended remarks, click and drag the splitter bar at the top of the property description panel to increase its height and display the additional information. Let's take a minute to describe a few of the commonly used Essbase connection properties. Under the Essbase category, you'll notice the server, application, and database properties, all of which were populated by the Essbase connection import wizard. These properties represent three of the five pieces of information required to connect to an Essbase database. The other two pieces of information required are the username and password. By default, the username and password property values are left blank, so that the end user will be required to enter his or her Essbase credentials in order to connect to the database. If you have a situation in which you don't want your end users to supply their own credentials, then you can provide a single set of credentials here that will be used for all users. Imagine a case in which you want to have your users log in and validate using their own credentials, but you don't want to give those users update or calculation privileges on the database. You might, in this case, want to have all of your calc and update operations occur using a single connection. With Dodeca, you can set up an additional sample basic connection that has a username and password provided. Then, behind the scenes, you can use that connection to perform the required update and calc operations. The information category is for the most part self-explanatory, but we should discuss the ID property briefly. The value of the ID property is sample.basic, and you'll notice that the ID is read-only at this point. In Dodeca, once an ID is committed to the database, it typically becomes read-only. This is the case because IDs are often used for reference in other objects, and a connection ID is used to identify the connection object throughout the Dodeca system. Under the logging category, there are two properties, do Essbase performance logging and do request response logging. When do Essbase performance logging is set to true and your server is properly configured for performance logging, Dodeca will insert records into a relational database for every single Essbase operation, providing metrics about the performance of your Essbase server. Do request response logging is used primarily by administrators to help understand the XML traffic that's traveling between the server and client machine. It can also be valuable in debugging situations. Under the miscellaneous category, the servlet path is the location on your network where the Dodeca client can contact the Dodeca Essbase service for all Essbase metadata and data needs. The address used here must be reachable from the client machine, so depending on your network setup, some companies may require a fully qualified domain name. The stateless property determines whether the connection is held on the Essbase server or not for each call. By default, this is set to true, meaning that every time Dodeca performs an operation, a retrieval for example, Dodeca will log into Essbase, retrieve the data, and then log off. Each operation is therefore a discrete connection. This property originates from the early days of Essbase when licensing was done on a concurrent user basis, but many companies prefer to use the stateless property in order to reduce the load on their Essbase servers. Let's take a look at a few additional features of this metadata editor. In the center pane, you'll see a number of buttons. Go ahead and create a new Essbase connection by pressing New. In the dialog that appears, type in an ID. For this example, we'll use demo.basic. Typically, we use the same information for both the ID and the name, but this is entirely optional. Both the ID and the name may contain spaces, but we recommend Essbase connections be named in the following format: application name dot database name. We recommend this format because typically, when moving an application from development to staging to production, your server names may change, but the application and database names typically don't. And using this format helps prevent any additional confusion during that migration. Go ahead and use demo basic for the name as well, and then hit OK. While we could have imported this connection using the wizard, Let's go ahead and fill in the required properties. Specify the application, demo, the database, basic, and the server name, which in our case is demo2010. Finally, we'll specify the servlet path, which in our environment is http://demo2010:13080/dodeca-sbase. At this point, you can test the connection by pressing Test Connection over in the center pane. When prompted, provide your Essbase username and password, and then press OK. Dodeca will attempt to make the connection to Essbase, and you'll be prompted with the results. If the test is connected successfully, press OK. And at this point, we'll commit the new connection to the relational database. Notice that in the selection pane, there's an icon next to the newly created demo.basic to indicate that the connection has been added. Additionally, the commit button is enabled at the bottom of the window, indicating that the changes have not been saved to the database. By pressing the commit button, we'll save all the changes to the database. Go ahead and press commit, and then click yes to commit all the changes. At this point, we've successfully set up two Essbase connections.